Good morning from NASA's Johnson Space Center. This is Mission Control Houston. You're looking at the International Space Station Flight Control Room once again. A team of flight controllers watching over systems aboard the orbiting complex. The team once again today is being led by Flight Director Greg Whitney. He is side-saddled by Mark Regan, who is serving there in the dark shirt as the communications link between the flight control team here and the crew aboard the International Space Station. The orbiting complex is just about to move into an orbital sunset as it tracks northeasterly across the southwestern Indian Ocean. The next landmass coastal crossing will be Thailand as it heads northeasterly, about a 45-minute pass through the dark on the dark side of the Earth before the next sunrise. As the station circles the Earth every 92 minutes at a speed of 17,500 miles per hour, that's about 5 miles per second. The crew on board Expedition 34 is comprised of Commander Kevin Ford and Oleg Novitsky and Yevgeny Tarelkin. Those three on the left in this view of the crew's logo began their voyage aboard the International Space Station back on October 25th following a two-day launch to docking rendezvous that began with a launch on October 23rd. They're scheduled to return home late in the evening of Monday, March 14th. Aboard their Soyuz TMA-06M spacecraft. The other three crew members you see there on the right side of the logo are the newest crew members, although now they have been in space for a little more than a month. They're comprised of seated there, Chris Hadfield with the Canadian Space Agency, and then behind him, the taller of the two, is Russian cosmonaut Roman Romanenko, and then on the far right is astronaut Dr. Tom Marshburn. The original three, or the first three crew members, have been aboard the station for 92 days now and in space for 94, and the other three have been in space now for 37 days, 35 of those aboard the International Space Station. The crew members have focused their attention today on some housekeeping chores and some science activities aboard the orbiting complex that will end their day at about 3:30 in the afternoon, and they wake up each day about midnight U.S. Central Time. Focus today is on some experiment work, as mentioned, including the in-space experiment designed to investigate fluids containing ellipsoid-shaped particles, and also working with some additional maintenance activities back in the U.S. airlock Quest. Also, the crew members have been taking turns performing some ultrasound testing in the human research arena, and that has been going on throughout the day today for the crew members as well. Exercise, another part of their daily routine, as is conversations periodically with the ground here in Mission Control Houston and other flight control centers that support the International Space Station activities on board.